In this demo, we're going to be looking at Azure Policy in Kubernetes. Organizations have all different kinds of policies, some of which are required to meet governance and legal requirements, others to ensure adherence to best practices and conventions defined in the organization. Historically, these policies have been managed and enforced manually or through a set of bespoke tools. The Open Policy Agent, a CNCF project, seeks to make this process standardized, declarative, and automated. Azure Policy makes OPA policies easy to set up and manage, and can be combined with both AKS clusters running in the cloud and Arc-connected clusters running in other environments. In this demo, we're going to look at Azure Policy in the context of AKS. We'll first use the Azure Policy UI to set up a single audit-only policy for one of our resource groups. Then we'll review the results of that audit and see how to use it to find resources which are out of compliance. Then we'll look at how you can use policy initiatives to replicate the capabilities of the Kubernetes pod security policy feature in a standard OPA compliant way, and see what happens when we try to deploy a resource that violates such a policy. Enabling Azure Policy for AKS is simple and can be done through the portal or the CLI. In a few minutes, the policy add-on will be installed and the cluster will be ready to apply policies. Azure Policy comes with a set of built-in policies that are commonly used by organizations that are running Kubernetes in production. Let's take a look at how we can assign one of those policies to our AKS clusters. So within the Assignments UI, I'll choose Assign Policy. Now, when I create an assignment, I have the opportunity to create a scope, which means choosing the Azure subscription and optionally the resource group that I want to have that policy apply to. Then I can optionally choose a set of excluded resources if there are resources within that scope that I don't want to have the policy apply to. Next up, I choose the policy definition, and this is where we can see the set of built-in policies that are available. So if I search for Kubernetes, I'll see a few dozen built-in policies with descriptions of the definition of that policy. So in this case, I'm going to choose limiting load balancer services to only be internal load balancers, so not exposing any external IPs. Then I can give the policy assignment a name. Then under the Parameters tab, I have a couple of important options. First, I can choose the effect of the policy. So by default, this particular policy is set to deny, which means that any service I try to deploy that would create an external load balancer will be blocked by the gatekeeper admission controller. Now, in this case, we're adding this policy to an existing cluster. We want to make sure that we're not breaking any existing workflows that our developers may have. So I'm actually going to change this to audit, which means that any resources that are out of compliance will be audited, will be visible within the Azure Policy UI. They will not immediately block deployments of those resources. I can also choose a set of namespaces within my cluster that I want to be excluded from this policy, and there's a set that are built in. So then I'll go ahead and create that assignment. Now, once that policy is created, I can go over to the compliance experience and find the assignment that I just created. And this is where I'll be able to get a view of my compliance state relative to that policy definition that I just deployed. Now, initially, this is going to be in a not started state. It'll take a few minutes for the policy to get deployed to that set of clusters and for the audit to run and for those results to be reported back up into Azure Policy and visible in this UI. And then on an ongoing basis, that audit will happen every 15 minutes. So within 15 minutes, you always have up-to-date state of the policy and compliance within your cluster. And after a few minutes, I can hit refresh here. And see that I'm out of compliance because there is this one resource that is not compliant with that policy assignment that I just created. And that is this external LB service within the policy demo cluster. So I can pop open the Cloud Shell and take a look at that cluster and see if indeed there is an external load balancer service. And there it is, that external LB service that was referenced within the policy experience. And indeed, you can see that it has been assigned an external IP, so it is in violation of that policy. So now let's take a look at how we can use Azure Policy Initiatives to enforce pod security policies. So once again, I go to Assignments, but in this case, I'll choose Assigned Initiatives. And again, I'll choose my scope, including the resource group that I want to apply this initiative to. Now I'm going to choose the initiative definition. Now, an initiative is a set of policies that are combined together into a holistic group. And in this case, what we've done is taken the pod security policies that were defined in Kubernetes as a beta capability and made them available as an Azure Policy Initiative. So in this case, I'm choosing the pod security policy baseline. And then within parameters, by default, these are set to be audit, but in this case, we're going to look at what happens when we explicitly deny any resources that are not in compliance with that policy. Now again, the initiative is made up of a set of individual policies, including things like blocking host network access, host volume access. In this case, we're going to look at the policy that blocks privileged containers. So I've got a simple pod spec here that defines a container that is requesting privileged access, so requesting the ability to interact with the host machine. And I'm just going to go ahead and try to apply that pod spec to the cluster. And immediately you will see an error that is returned directly from the gatekeeper admission controller that is telling me that privileged containers are not allowed. So it's being blocked based on that policy definition that was part of that larger initiative. So wrapping up, OPA enables policy management for cloud-native environments. And as we saw, Azure Policy and AKS make consuming OPA policies really easy. You have full control over the scope of those policies application and the enforcement. You can even take Kubernetes pod security policy and apply those in an Azure Policy environment using initiatives. And finally, everything that you saw today in the context of AKS can equally be applied to Arc-connected Kubernetes clusters. So if you're running Kubernetes clusters in other environments and want to share policies across those environments, you can do that with Azure Arc. Here are some resources for documentation around the Azure experience, including how to apply pod security policy, and pointers to some of the upstream projects of interest, like the Open Policy Agent and Gatekeeper. Thank you very much.